So Bleach could be in trouble, and here's why. Bleach is one of the most anticipated series of the fall 2022 lineup of anime, followed by Chainsaw Man, My Hero Academia, Blue Lock, and other series. Therefore, we are completely stacked with series that there is a lot to choose from, and it is really going to be a fight for what really comes out on top. However, how we consume these series on a weekly basis is usually by Crunchyroll or by piracy. But to get to the point of the video, there has been, for the past few months, as a source has been telling me, is that there's been a bit of a bidding war between Crunchyroll and Disney Plus. And while Disney Plus, or Disney in general, well, I don't have the biggest faith in it because Disney is a very family-friendly thing, but recently they've been dabbling a bit into anime, especially with Summertime Rendering and how gory and edgy that series kind of is. There's a part of me that's a little bit more hopeful, but at the same time, does it really do that weekly simulcast that we kind of want that Crunchyroll offers? And if it does, I mean, I'm a little bit more hopeful, but at the same time, something just doesn't sit right with me. And there's multiple factors of why this is the case. But to give a little bit of context about the Crunchyroll and Disney kind of fighting for the bidding war kind of thing that I was talking about, is that it's kind of like Burn the Witch, where Crunchyroll and Netflix were kind of going back and forth with the bidding for that, because again, I was told that Crunchyroll didn't really have much faith in Burn the Witch doing well, because again, it didn't have any source material, so they didn't really have any research to see how well it would do. And because I believe Aniplex was asking for quite a bit of money that Crunchyroll didn't really seem viable to really spend, but they did anyway, and kudos to them because they made the right decision, even though that they could have Googled and seen how popular Burn the Witch was before the manga even dropped in the first place. But I digress, because we won't really go into Crunchyroll's decision making now, will we? Because how many millions did you waste on original content, Crunchyroll, and how did that work out for you? Ooh, not so good now, did it? Anyway, besides the point, Bleach is a very anticipated show, and I think Disney and Crunchyroll know this to some extent, but Bleach has an extremely high price tag on it, and for the right reasons too. Because of this, Disney has money and Crunchyroll just simply do not, and especially with all the money that I imagine Crunchyroll has been putting in to the mass amounts of licensing that this fall season has been dropping us. Again, Chainsaw Man has probably had a big price tag to it, as well as Blue Lock, and again My Hero Academia, and probably other series that come along with it. We are completely stacked, and I imagine Crunchyroll has probably tapped in a bit of its budget already. So, you know, fighting with Bleach at the moment with Disney Plus is a bit of a, like, it's gonna hurt the bank if Bleach didn't do well, which I imagine it would. I have no qualms about that whatsoever. It's just what you believe that Crunchyroll value Bleach as in terms of money. Would Disney Plus do Bleach right? I do believe that they would. The only thing that slightly concerns me is the weekly simulcast, because if it's not weekly simulcast, they're gonna lose. Actually, I don't know if they'll lose a bit of money, but I know that a lot of people are going to pirate. However, 10 million Crunchyroll subscribers in comparison to 110 plus subscribers, 130 plus maybe, I can't remember the numbers off the top of my head, plus subscribers from Disney, you know, could actually weigh that out. I mean, regardless of all the people pirating Bleach, I do think the same amount of people that would actually watch Bleach on Disney Plus that aren't in the community are probably going to make up for what Crunchyroll would have got if people didn't pirate anyway. So again, I'm kind of on the fence on that one. I know that Disney Plus actually does market a lot better than Crunchyroll ever does, and especially with the TV adverts that they do and the social media posts that they do and the amount of actual professionalism that they ensue in comparison to Crunchyroll is kind of uplifting to a certain degree. However, I think new fans that are going to see Bleach and get into Bleach, if it was on Disney Plus, is going to be a bit weird, because they wouldn't really have a backlog to go watch the context of the series before getting to the final arc. So that's also a bit of a concern as well. Now, people are going to bring up, well, what about Viz? Viz also has bought the rights to, you know, the DVD video home releases, the dubbing, most likely, and also just merchandising in general. But Viz Media have never had, to my knowledge anyway, video streaming service rights. That's always been to Crunchyroll. And then if he was in the UK, for example, Manga Entertainment would have the rights, and then they would give those rights to Netflix UK, for example, and then they would distribute it, which is also known as sub-licensing. Now, again, people are going to say, oh, well, what about Funimation? They've got the dubbed episodes of like 100 plus episodes of Bleach. Well, yeah, because Crunchyroll just bought them out. It's not a partnership, it's a buyout. So, I mean, that kind of probably follows suit with Crunchyroll's license as well. Point is, there is a bidding war at the moment, and that's why you haven't seen Crunchyroll actively promote Bleach as they have Chainsaw Man currently at the moment. And ultimately, it doesn't really matter how much these companies spend, because it's not going to affect Bleach in the slightest. It's not going to improve animation. It's not going to lessen animation. It's not going to change anything, because Bleach is kind of already fully funded, or it already has its investors, and none of the licenses are invested in the actual investment of the production of the show itself, like some seasonal anime are. Sometimes a licensor such as Netflix will put towards Baki, for example, and they'll give money to that, or maybe money to JoJo's. They'll have a piece of the investment pie, and usually they get a say on how things are usually done. Give or take, I'm just giving it a surface level face value. But the point is that Bleach is happening regardless of if we get a licensor or not. So if you want to be a pirate, be a pirate. So I guess because I am so conflicted, and I was hesitant to make this video because I hope this video does age like milk, I guess I kind of wanted your guys' thoughts and discussions in the comment section down below, unironically, about what you would prefer. Because at the same time, Disney is massive. It has a massive amount of influence. And if, you know, it does well on Disney, then we could see a really good reception for Bleach in the future. However, the conveniency of Crunchyroll, as we've always used it, is more applicable, and all the catalogue of the previous episodes are there as well. But how well could they actually treat Bleach in the future in compared to something like Disney? We don't really know, and I guess that fear of not knowing is what the scary outcome is. But I feel I should end it off with this note as well. Crunchyroll, of all the things I've ever criticized you on, if you do not get the Bleach IP and you give it to Disney Plus, I mean, good for Disney Plus, I suppose. Like, again, there's benefits to it as well, but I'd be extremely disappointed at your incompetence to not see a moneymaker when it's there, when people have asked you for years to get it or have some influence in towards it, as well as choosing 40,000 different isekai shows that do mid every single month over Bleach is quite a stupid business move, in my personal opinion. Non-bias, I'm just saying that from a market perspective. Because to be quite honest, I don't think anyone in their right mind is finishing work after a hard day of like 12 hours, rushing home to sit down to watch Reincarnated as a Sword, to be quite honest, over Bleach. That would be insanity. But hey, maybe I'm out the loop here, and maybe I'm just a fucking boomer. Who knows? Or maybe I just haven't fallen into the amounts of degeneracy yet. But yeah, it's something I wanted to talk about. So, is Bleach in danger of its reach? Can it reach the audience it needs to? Would having Disney Plus be a good thing? Or will it ultimately have Chainsaw Man overshadow Bleach if it's not done simulcast? I'll have to leave that to public opinion. But with that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.